Hey, it's KMA. How's your day today? And welcome to the Korner. We are in my Hobbit abode. The little place I call home in Hobbiton. And my... oh my gosh. My farmers are multiplying. Again. What? You got Hamson? Hamson. All right, go get the bunny. Go get the bunny. Yeah, go kill that thing. Oh my gosh. yeah, there's some duplication going on with my farmers here, and I do not know why. I would also like to know why you, supposedly, I can hire sheriffs with my alignment and everything, and it's not happening. But that is not what we're going to be focusing on today. Today we are focusing on... there's a problem with the Lord of the Rings map. It's a little big. I'm just saying, it's just a little big. And one of the best ways to get around on the map is riding mounts. And I don't have a mount. I don't have a good horse. I've been told that in the Shire, horses really are not that good. And I need to go down here to Rohan to get a horse. So guess what we are going to be doing? We are going to go to Rohan in this episode. We're going to get ourselves a horse. We're going to get ourselves an awesome horse. And hopefully we don't lose that horse. Maybe we'll get a couple horses, I don't know. And maybe if we want to, and we might go to the Misty Mountains and see if we can get ourselves some mithril. Because we could use some mithril. I'm just seeing what I should bring for this journey, because it is kind of a long journey. But I don't really have that much. As you see, my chests are empty. I got like little bits of stuff in here, and let's see what types of stuff and things we got in here. Not much really, but I think we're just gonna go because we can find food on the way. I'm hoping, not famous last words. So I'm just gonna go with, I'm gonna take this wheat with us. We can just make this wheat up real quick. Let me get to here and we'll just make some more bread. So we're gonna go, and the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna try out this fast travel system. So like I say, the areas in the lighter beige are areas that are unlocked. To unlock new areas, you kind of have to go to that area. So once I step into this land right here, this waypoint, or maybe that one, I can't tell if that one's in this area, will unlock and I can fast travel to the next place. There is a cooldown time which shortens up over time. But seeing I'm recording videos, cheat number two, I told you about cheat number one, which is keep items on when I die, because I believe that all mods, packs, when you die, there's a way to get your stuff back, because mods have so much material on them that if you lose everything, there's no reason to continue. Well, it is really tough to recover from it, because there's just so much more product in modded situations than normal vanilla, so I put the keep inventory on. And also there's a cooldown time with fast travel, which I have turned off for video and streaming reasons only. I'm not going to abuse it. And another thing I will say before we continue, because you see that my waypoints are also shown in weird areas out here, I think Mordor also, because on one of my streams I decided to go into creative mode and just check out some worlds. But that doesn't mean if I want to go to Mordor right now, I'm going to go click here and fast travel here. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to do this legit. If I wanted to go to Mordor, I would be doing this traveling. So, believe me, there's waypoints open down here, but I'm not going to use them. You're just going to have to trust me on that. So, let us just go to fast travel mode. And we're going to go far, far away, guys. I wonder if when I come back, how many of you guys are gonna be. We are making clones of farmers for some reason. Do not understand. So here we are. The world is loading up for me. We are now at Solon Forge, and we gotta go east. And look, that already gave way the fast travel points to these other areas. But I think I am just gonna go and hoof it. So I wanna check out these areas, take a look at the new places that we have, and see if anything of interest is down here. Nice little bridge for the ford. And I don't know if this means like at night there's bad people here. I guess we can find out if there's bad people in this cave. I don't see bad people down there. So I'm really excited with the Lord of the Rings mod. The areas, the biomes are huge. I wonder if this horse is a good horse. Excuse me, separate you two. Let me get on you. Because I know the horses of the Shire kind of stink. So we'll see if the horses of wherever I am now. And Minhirieth, I don't know if I'm saying that right. You can tell me how to pronounce it in the comments below, because I know there's some people that are going to be upset with the way I pronounce certain things. But that's okay. I can handle it. I'm a big, strong person. Did you tame for me? Did you? Oh, you did. Let's go for a ride, guy. Oh. A shocking truth of... the hippity-skippity of the world. Okay, there's some stuff going on over there. I'm going to, before the next recording session, I'm going to add some more memory to the game. So, Iron Sword, we got plus 6. We got the Dwarven Warhammer. We can try the Dwarven Warhammer. Let's try 10. Okay. The Dwarven Warhammer seems like the best one to use. Achievement, Into the Kindly West. And from what I understand, the Kindly West is not too kindly. Are you gonna be mad with me? No, you don't really care for me. So let me pillage your area first. Yeah, and I'm gonna steal some of these torches because you know what? I do want to collect all the different types of lights there are in the world. Nice thing. Is that a shield? Yeah. Nice. Take the iron axe. We'll steal your stuff a little bit. Can I take you? Let me see. Axe. Where's the axe? Shut up. It sounds like you're burping, guy. And it's just, you know, not the best sound in the world. Just saying. You gotta get some manners, dude. What is your name? Do I need to teach you some manners? What's your name? Do you have a name, guy? You look like you could be a scary dude. I don't know if I want to fight you. But you know what? This is a Lord of the Rings mod, and you are on the side that I am not going to be protecting, so... Oh, I do not know exactly what this Orc Forge does, but I know that I want it. I gotta look that up. And yes, I'm stealing all these guys' torches. So let's take this guy on. Hey. Hey, dude. Guess what? Can you hit me? Can you hit me? Other than just making these weird sounds? Ooh. Orc Slayer. Achievement. Got stronger, stronger, stronger. That means I'm pretty sure that the orcs in this area are not going to like me too much when I see them in the future. Hey, rabbit guy. Guess what? So let's continue. We'll pretend we did not see that area. Can I get on this guy with... Okay, I can. So we'll continue on, and hopefully we will live some more. So here I am on my adventures in the middle of a cave with lots of bad things around me. I've decided to sneak my way into... the Misty Mountains to get myself some mithril. And I don't have any mithril yet, and I've been fighting my buns off, and I'm almost out of food. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, let's try and get some mithril. And I just realized I actually do have a sword, which, I mean, not a sword, a bow, so I can shoot some of these guys instead of just going randomly around and dying. So let's kill some guys, maybe. And not get kicked into the lava. That would be a good thing. And keep our eyes open for mithril. There's lots of things in these caves. Wish I could pick these up. I don't really know how to pick those up. I don't know if you're allowed to pick those up or not. But, we have some things. And seeing, I don't know if this is a Misty Mountain things or what, but glowstone. Yeah, we're getting tons of glowstone. I must have put it someplace. And we can get tons of this stuff, which is 10, I believe. Don't really need to get it, but I'm just doing it just so you guys can see me collecting some. And, you know, coal. Yeah, we got plenty of coal. No need to do that. So let's go around and kill some guys and maybe find a way out. Because I've been down here for a long time. A very long time. And I haven't found cuck-a-doodle-doo. And that's just saltpeter. But I have found a lot of mobs, which has made this journey a little more interesting than I have originally planned on it. So we can just keep going around. I don't know where all the mobs are now. I was in not a death cycle. I haven't died since I've been down here, which is good. But I've had to run away and hide and wait for my health to rejuvenate, eat some foods, and hide like a little baby. But you know, we won't hold that against me, because you know, if you see people with shiny bright eyes looking at you, teeth and swords and poison daggers and things, yeah, it just makes the vacation time a little less interesting, or a little less fun, I should say. Not interesting. And I'm guessing the amount of mithril in the area is extremely light, because I haven't been able to find diddly squat, none whatsoever. And I've been like running around these caves for a while, but it's been fun. Just happened to be in a lull now because, you know, I'm recording. We'll probably see some soon. Some meanies. Some mithril, maybe. But, yeah, I thought it would be a good idea. I think I was a little underprepared for mines like this. And, I don't know if the mob spawned with light. I am going to take all the glowstone, though, because I love glowstone. I really do. Oh, I could use it all day long. Is that a place I've been? That's probably a place I've been. Alright. So I'm going to look around, see if anything interesting happens. And if something interesting does happen, I will be right back. Speaking of interesting. And this is a problem I'm having. These guys have arrows. And I, just until recently, have not. So I haven't been able to really fight back. Which is fine. And I don't have many arrows, but this guy's pretty good. And he's pretty strong, so I'm going to use all my arrows to kill this guy. Does this guy have an arrow too? I say we just come after him like a... Well, he does have an arrow. I have 6 of them left, why not? One more. I do notice that some of these guys have been potioned out. Which is kind of scary. They have potions, and I do not. You crazy, guys. And I get a couple more arrows. Waste 6, gain 2. That's lovely. Oh, don't want to jump down there too much. I don't know what's creating the spiders, because I haven't seen any spiders. I hear the guys grunting at me all the time, and I just don't see them. Well, on to looking for some more metal. We'll see if we ever see any, but these caves are magnificently huge. Like, come on, look at this. If I get shot from behind, I'm dead. But look at this! And no mithril. I guess this stuff is really, really hard to find. Alright, I'm not too sure what this is. What is going on here? Are these like hot springs or something? This gonna hurt me? I am confused. I do not want to know what's going on here. Weird. Is this some sort of specialty waterfall? But at least it doesn't hurt me, so I guess yay for the intriguing nothing. Make some more torches and continue. See, oh, I've lost my pants. That's not good. Well, I've given up the search for mithril, so I'm gonna stair step out of here. And we're gonna go on. I had a live stream the other day, and I actually went to Rohan. And I actually found myself a Rohan steed, and on my travels, some Yurikai decided to put a bomb next to it, and my steed had blown up. So I'm going to go back to Rohan and get myself a horse. But I want to make sure, I'm not 100% sure if I grabbed a replacement horse, but it was not a Rohan horse. So I'm not too worried about that, because I do want a Rohan steed, and I want a white one, and I want it to look like Shadowfax. So I'm gonna get out of here, and I'm gonna go and get myself another steed, and then we can head back home and think about our next journey. Come on, nothing hanging out to say boo and scare the living crap out of me. Let's get this guy. Wait, let's click this so you guys can see this. Oh, and it's one of these guys. I have the hardest time with the guys with the arrows because they run. They shoot you, then they run away. Which is like... not the best thing to do when you don't have arrows, because you just want to go and get the guy, and he just keeps on running and shooting you like you're a loser. But anyways, this cave seems pretty empty. Let's continue to get our booty up and out of here. Uh-oh. Yurikai guy. And he's got the poison on me. Jerk face. Oh, run away, run away, run away. Come on. What a thing you've got there, guy. Jeez. I think I just picked up something. Where did he came from up there? Okay. What did I just pick up? No, I don't know. Did I pick something up? It might have went into one of my boxes. Alright. Yep. Scary, scary stuff. But let's continue onward and forward. I have made it out of my cave. And I wanted to show you what the Misty Mountains look like. I'm standing on one of the pyres, and I think I went down right below my head. But this is the edge of the Misty Mountains. You can kind of see over there where I came in. So I'm going to go check out my camp over there, And we're going to go to Rohan and get myself another steed, and hopefully this one will not get blown up by a bomb left by a Yurikai. We are back in Rohan to find ourselves a horse. We found some horses over here and some dudes. So let's see what the dudes want. Hey dudes, what do you want? Greetings, what tidings do you bring to the Ritterbark? I don't know what tidings I bring to you, so I'm clueless and slightly slack. What business do you have in the Ritterbark? Still clueless and slightly slack, but yeah, whatever. I hope you're not forgetting to feed those horses. I mean, these horses? Which one would I like to take today? I really kind of would like a nice white one, but you know what? I had a white one prior, and I felt so bad when it got blown up that I just can't see myself bringing myself to getting another white horse, so I'm going to go with one that looks like Tonto. Was that the end? I don't know. I don't remember if that was the horse's name or not. I'm old, but I'm not that old. I didn't watch that show. Lone Ranger. Nope. Hey? Do I have you? I do have you. Oh. And we need to make a thing real quick. How do I make these things? Let me get off you. It's 3 leather. I do have 3, I think. Hold on, let me find. Yes, 3. Hi. You're all happy. You're happy that you're mine. I'm really glad that you're happy that you're going to come to the Shire with me. And there we go. We got our saddle. We can throw you right on there. And then we can throw it. Oh, you are okay. I'll take you. You're better than the Shire horse. And I'm not going to be too picky in front of the Ridmark guys. So, that means we have ourselves a journey back home. Because we did what we wanted to. We wanted to go to the Misty Mountains. We did not get any mithril in there. But we did check out the Misty Mountains. And we got ourselves a steed. So, we need to head west back to our home. I guess this is the way. So we've got a long journey ahead of us, but a fun one indeed. And I will probably catch back with you when I get home. And then we can check on our farmers and see if we have 4 duplicates of each. Or if the game has reverted itself and we are back to normal with only the one of each. Now, I don't want to hold my food in my hand. I don't trust these birds at all. In this world, they'll come down and swoop and take your stuff. Hey guys, what's up? How you doing? You're living life? Hello. You can be attached to my front door. I hope you enjoy your new home. You matched the house pretty well, almost perfectly actually. I did well in my choice of you. I appreciate all the help and all that traveling. That was pretty awesome there, I must say. And I gotta figure out what to call you. I'm not gonna call you Tonto because that's borderline racist, but we'll call you something sometime soon. Let's check out what we've got an overload of farmers now. I do not know what is going on here. There's some shenanigans going on. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of Hansons. Is that what your name was? Hamson? Jeez. Command, let's see what your inventory. You got 18. Wait, I wonder if all of these have 18 or something like that. 19. Oh my gosh. Command, open. Wow. Yeah, we've got some things to be doing and some way to fix this. But you know what? They're doing very well. I don't know if this is cheaty inventory that I'm getting right now, or if these are actual. Did you not have any seeds? Oh, you got plenty of seeds on you. Or if I'm not sure if the farm is itself duplicating. So I don't know if the 15 I'm getting from him is just 15 that I would have from a single one, and it's just duplicated itself onto the others because these guys have keeps duplicating, and I can't really kill them because that's just bad, right? But I don't know. I don't know if this is cheaty or not. Let me know in the comments whether or not you think this is cheaty. I'm in South Midland, taking a look at some of these places, grabbing some of my favorite looking torches. I love these things. These things are so awesome. I can need some banners. These are the places I would love to be part of because they like the blue. Yes, that's right. They like the blue. I like the blue. So I gotta love this area. Let me check that out. Where's South Midland? I should grab one of these. Actually, this works as an axe. Yeah, we'll take one. I don't know. This is high elf territory. I'm just kind of going around and checking out some areas. I think I have already checked the chest up here. Well, maybe there is no chest up here. So I guess there is no chest up here. So this guy, I accepted a thing. I need a book from him, though. I need to kill some orcs to satisfy that guy. So let's go fast travel back home and end the episode. And I just wanted to show you the continual duplication of my farmers. And look at all my guys. Look at all these guys. I've expanded my, I mentioned this in the Dark Times server Discord. So just expand your farms a little bit. But I can't believe how many people, this came from two people. So yeah, it's kind of weird, but let's see, open inventory. They're all kind of low on inventory right now just because there's so many of them and there's only a certain amount of plants. I also was able to finally get this block for up there to match this one, and I think it looks, I mean, the block doesn't really match the design of the build at all, but it fits, and it lights up the place, so I give it a thumbs up. I got the Orc Forge, which helps out, and I got some other cool stuffs around. We should probably place this crafting table somewhere important. I'll throw it right there. I don't know what I can craft in that. Oh, and I stole a high elven bed. One of the things I want to do in this is to kind of collect all the different beds because I think that would kind of look cool, having them all right next to each other. But anyways, I'm going to call it for today. Look at my armor. I've been going around killing things, trying to get some extra money and stuff and things, and I'm doing pretty good with that. Next episode, I do not know exactly what I'm going to do. But I will figure that out before we start recording it. We'll probably have some sort of traveling going on. Maybe a little bit of building somewhere. But I haven't decided. But thank you guys for watching this episode. And I will see you guys later. And have a great day. Goodbye.